Yeah.
Same. Who do you go to? Do you do it yourself?
I do it myself. Go to Kicks. Kicks is my gym. I go 5 days a week.
Physical training?
Yeah.
What about vocal training?
No, I don't do that.
It's amazing.
I do need to, but I don't.
No, you turned up, you stood on that stage, you went straight to the mic, and it was like an instrument that had...
But honey, look how old I am now.
I've been doing it since I was
years old.
Yeah.
You know, it's like...
It's your instrument.
It's second nature. You know, you're not even thinking about it. It's just...
No.
You do it, isn't it? It's like
your confidence is fabulous.
Well, it's not confidence, it's just
it's
you've been
knowledge.
Doing it.
Your knowledge.
Yeah, but you still shit yourself.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, I'm always scared.
Are you?
It just doesn't show, but inside I'm freaking out.
Did you go to stage school with?
No.
What did you do?
Me? Stage school. My parents couldn't afford that stuff.
No.
Right.
No, honey.
So
I come from Lewisham.
When did you start?
I was born in funny, my mother had 6 children.
Yeah.
I'm the third girl.
You've got one of five.
Yeah. But there are 3 girls and 3 boys, like the Brady Bunch. And I was the last girl. And then the boys began after me.
Yeah.
Okay.
Basically, all of the kids were born in Lambeth. I'm the only one that was born in Islington.
Yeah.
And my mum moved for 5 seconds while she was pregnant with me and decided that was where she was going to live for 5 seconds. Had
and
me,
then went back.
And
yeah.
then went back.
Right.
So I'm the freak of the family and
yeah.
then I was born somewhere
in
else.
Right.
So I don't know if that's anything to do with it. But my grandparents took over
yeah.
and brought me up. And my grandparents are, you know, my grandfather's a minister.
Yeah.
And so we were like the first family of the church. So we had to... We had to do everything perfect.
So did you sing in the church? Was that
my whole life.
Brought up? Right, okay.
From the time I was 6 years old, I did my first rendition at 6, and then basically I won my first award in the Pentecostal Church of God organization
yeah.
when I was 11.
Right.
Are you religious?
Not at all.
Okay.
No.
Not at all, but I'm spiritual.
But spiritual,
okay.
yeah,
but brought up in that ethos and everything.
Oh, but they were very, they were very hardcore.
Yeah.
I mean, they were
hardcore.
Like, you know, my granddad was a proper minister,
yes.
Bible basher, he'll go to hell,
yeah,
he was that
hell,
kind of guy.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, he was all of that, yeah, yeah. No, just being in the business.
Just being in the business.
Because
when
I
basically...
Singing
the devil's music.
Yeah, exactly.
Quincy Jones is
the same. His mother used to
turn
up.
Turn
yeah.
up to gigs and hit him.
Hit him with a stick.
Oh yeah, no. My grandfather said to me, because I was a big star in the church.
I know it's not.
So their conventions, when I won that competition when I was 11, that was in front of the Wembley, filled with
yes.
people.
Yeah.
That's the conventions. They fill up Wembley. It was in Wembley.
And
that's where they happened.
Yeah.
So imagine at 11, I was like, I was
yes.
really scared. I was the youngest of the contestants,
yeah.
you know, and
yeah.
I was like, there's no way I'm in this, you know, and this is just rubbish. And I couldn't believe that I won it. I was like,
what were your sisters? Do they sing? Or?
Yeah, my sister is a praise and worship person
oh,
in church,
right.
Ruach.
Yeah.
My
yeah.
sister does praise and worship for them. She's made she made her own album, a gospel
wow.
album. She, Paula, I call her Paula, her name is Alicia Mark now.
Right.
She used to, Alison Mark, sorry, she changed her name so many times. She's got three names.
Trying to get far away from you as possible,
no.
that for some reason.
It's not even that, bless her,
no.
it's not that. She got married and basically
yeah.
her name changed, and I can't get
yeah.
my head around the name change.
Yeah, yeah,
still,
yeah.
For me, she's still P.
Yeah.
Not Mrs. Mark. It's
yes.
like, whatever.
Yeah.
Anyway, he's a nice guy, but you know, it's like the name thing. So anyway, so she... My sister is, you know, she was a, she had a pop career for like 5 minutes, basically.
Yeah.
The song was called Discover Me.
Right.
Discover Me was a bit of a hit back in the
right.
day, and that was my sister. And then she
yes.
left that and then went to Jesus.
Right, oh,
okay.
interesting.
And she's been with Jesus ever since.
And does that cause conflict or anything with
no,
you?
No, not at all.
No.
They don't even bother now.
No.
They've tried so many times. When are you coming back? I'm like, never.
Yeah.
I said,
yeah.
I'm coming back when everyone in the church is a minister.
Yeah.
That's what I say.
No,
I'm saying they got
yeah.
quiet after that.
Yeah.
There's nothing
yeah.
they can really say.
Yeah.
By the way, we are at the Millfield Theatre in Edmonton for Ziggy's World Jazz Club's very first night here with legendary
yeah.
Misha Paris
yeah.
sounding better, if it's possible to say.
Really?
Yes.
Better
yes.
than ever.
Bless you. Bless
what
no,
about
I'm,
your
I'm,
career? What's happening with your career? Are you? I mean, because
a lot of people say that.
Good question.
If we don't see you on the telly,
say,
so you're dead.
Yes.
Before,
no, we have seen
you
on
answer,
the telly.
Can I just say what's
yeah.
happening with your career?
No, this is the start.
I'm so glad you're married. I wouldn't want to be here if you weren't.
Yes.
No, but no. What it is? I basically had this big TV career for 5 minutes.
Yeah.
Well, about 3 years,
yeah.
and then I got really sick of it. They would, I felt that they were trying to make me like, you know, like the new Mylene Kvas with colour.
Right,
you know,
yes.
Kind of thing, with a darker shade, actually.
Yes,
she's
darker
a, she's
shade.
A bit colourful.
Yeah.
Yeah, so...
more, yeah.
I just remembered
more
Mylene
than a lot,
Kvas
yeah.
is.
I've just remembered who she is.
Yeah.
And
it's
and
all
felt
that fashion stuff, you see, I
no,
don't read
that
magazine.
No, yeah,
I
studied fashion at college, you see, before
oh,
I became a singer. Yeah, and so basically I've always had it in me. It's
always
been
right.
there. Yeah, I used to design.
Where did you go?
I went to Vauxhall College.
Did you?
Yeah,
oh,
that's where
right.
I went to do my A-level art. My dad's an artist as well, he's amazing. So that's a part of me anyway, it was
that
always
there.
But that's why my grandparents were upset, because I was doing so well with that. And then
right.
I left that. I went straight to the music, because the music, I was making like a grand a week at
yes.
16.
Oh!
I was like...
Get into the music business,
like,
kids!
I don't think I want to design right now.
No.
So anyway, cut long story short.
Well, thank God for the music business, you didn't.
Yeah, so basically...
It's okay.
Al, you can do the list, baby, can't you?
One
with them.
Yeah, if she wants to do the set.
Please.
Okay.
I don't know how to something.
It's very sweet.
It's very sweet. You're very sweet, Alex. You can join in the interview as well. It's kind of the sort of Kenny Everett type style.
Yeah, it's
all. Are we still rolling?
Sorry.
Are we not
so
back
sorry. We're still rolling.
That's good.
But
so, Alex, we're on in 15 minutes. Don't want to wear the singer out, the turn out. Everyone can do a turn. I was brought up in showbiz.
Yeah, go on. What were you saying?
Yeah.
So, you're an artist, basically. Yeah.
Another couple.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because I said to you, ask her something that nobody knows about.
Yeah.
You said don't ask her any of that stuff.
I said get her into that stuff.
You can ask her.
Do you know what
anything.
I did? Do you know what I asked her? I googled questions to ask celebrities. I can't ask her
no,
that.
No, basically, we're huge fans, obviously.
And I appreciate it. Honestly,
you know,
sweet.
We moved to it at Spielberg last year.
Yeah,
and we talked. This woman is just
yeah.
stunning.
So you want to know about the what's happened with the career?
I want to know.
Oh, yeah, okay. So,
why the heck
TV,
you
wait,
want...
No, but hang on. No, TV, let me tell you what happened.
Yeah.
So, you know, obviously I got signed when I was 17.
Yes.
Album came out, double platinum,
yeah,
went and
yes.
toured the
yes.
world
yes.
and everything,
yeah.
whatever. Then the next album came.
Yeah.
Then I got sick of it. And then I was just like, enough. And I wanted to raise my little girl.
Yes.
I had my first kid.
Yes.
And I was married and everything else was wonderful. I had 5 years of just constant travelling around the world, living out of a suitcase.
Yes.
Got really sick of it. Took time out, had
yeah.
my kid and whatever. Then got back into it again and then had more hits with One and all
yes.
these other songs
yes.
in late 90s. And then I released an album called Black Angel.
Yeah.
Which was... I'll never make an album by myself again. It's a great album, but I did it all myself.
Yeah.
I'll never do that again. It's too
yeah.
much work.
Yes.
So anyway, but that was good to get it out of my system. I think every artist needs to do that.
Yes, I agree.
Then after that, I got asked to do a Radio 2 show.
Mm-hmm.
And I was taking over from Dionne Warwick.
Yes.
And she was tired of the show. And you know, I've been friends with her for a long time.
Yeah.
And she said, Misha, please, for Christ's sake, save me. So I was like, all right, look, I said, I don't really do radio, you know, but, she, you know, it was a guest. So
yeah.
I did a guest thing for her.
Yeah.
And then BBC called up and said, we want you to have a permanent show.
Yeah.
So then I basically stayed there for 5 years on Radio
yeah.
2, had the you know, biggest soul show on there.
That's
every
right.
Every Wednesday,
yeah.
9 o'clock, Wicked. Had everyone
yes.
down, Mary J, everybody.
Yeah.
And that was wonderful. And I think I was just at a point in my career where I just didn't, you see, I'm a little bit different from other artists. Most artists are killing themselves to be on television all the time.
Yes.
I'm kind of the opposite. I only want it when I want it.
When you want it.
And I'm not like a person who, I'm quite happy to play a small place like this and then play Wembley tomorrow.
Yes.
That's the kind of person I am.
I think that's laudable. I think that's a really interesting thing about you, that
yeah.
you are choosy like that. And you're not, as you say, killing everybody to get on stage or get on television.
No, I don't believe
that's
that.
Not important. You've got other things that are, your
it's
priorities
not that important
are
to
different.
Me. It's because I think when you've tasted the level of fame that I've had,
yes.
it's so maddening.
Yes.
And if you like being normal,
I quite
like going to Waitrose and buying
yeah.
my shopping. Do you
and
know,
you've
I
got
like
kids.
That.
Yeah.
So
yeah,
I dip in and out of it as
yeah.
opposed to being in it all the time, because
yeah.
I think that you can lose yourself.
Lose
I've seen
yourself.
It many times. This year it's 27 years I've been in the business,
yeah.
and I'm still feeling great about life. I'm not, you know, I feel good. I go home. I'm a mum. You know, Alex is my boyfriend. Bless him. And we have a wonderful family, and
yeah.
we have a very normal life. And then we go, we do stuff like this, or I do TV, or I do, and it's nice. I love my life.
You
I don't feel like, you know, I don't.
You're missing anything.
No, I don't feel like, my God, you should be as big as da da da. And I feel like that. No, I feel like I've done a lot in 27 years. I've worked with everybody. You know, Stevie, Prince, everyone. Well, Shaka Khan. I've done everybody. I've done everyone.
So you are a superstar who's a human being, basically.
Yeah, I think you have to keep it real like that because I learned when I was younger, when I went to work with Peter Gabriel, who's a really good friend of mine. He's a fantastic guy.
Yeah.
And Peter's, you know, when I went to work with Peter, I think I was about 20 at the time, and went down to Real World. He's got a studio in Bath. It's a fantastic place. And we went down and recorded. And I said, Peter, how do you do it, man? Because at that time, I was massive. I was everywhere.
Yes.
And I said to him, how do you do it? I mean, you're like, I'm a star, but you're like ridiculous. You're like Genesis and all that stuff. I said, how do you? And he's so normal.
No.
And I was like, I want to be like that. That's the kind of star I want to be. Who can, you know, I saw him in Tesco's 2 weeks ago. He lives right around the corner from me. He's moved to London now. He's in Notting Hill. Because I live in Holland Park, right?
Yeah.
And I see him in Tesco's all the time at the checkout.
Yeah.
And no one knows that this is
Peter Gabriel buying.
No one knows.
Jacob's Crackers.
He's that kind of person. And that's what I'm saying. I think you have to control it. I mean, now, I've always said, even in the beginning, I said, you know, I'll make an album when I feel like making an album.
Yeah.
But I feel it. You know, I don't feel it all the time. I don't feel what the record company feels. Yeah. The record company wants you to release a record like McDonald's every week.
Yes.
As you put out a record, you've got to put out another one. You have to live to make a record. You've got to sing about something. You've got to sing about something. If you're just churning it out like a conveyor belt, what the hell are you going to sing about? A conveyor belt, isn't it?
There's no happiness down that route.
No, it's not. It's rubbish. And I'm telling you now, if you know, I don't care what anyone says, fame is not natural.
I agree.
Oh, God.
It's not a natural place for human beings to be. It's weird. It makes you feel like you're losing your mind. And my thing was, shut the door. Oh, excuse me.
Yes.
It's okay.
I want my children, I want my life, I want me back. I felt like I was losing my mind, especially when I went to, when I blew up in the States on the first two records, I was like, I thought I was going mad.
Because
the people over there, they're worse. They're like, the fans follow you home, they sit outside your house and they take your clothes from the gigs. I mean, they're freaks.
I was like,
I don't want this.
No.
And everywhere I went, I had bodyguards. I was like, oh my God, I can't go to the shop without bodyguards. What's that? This is not alive.
So where do you think that humanity comes from then? Is that your parents or your grandparents?
Grandparents. Hands down, grandparents. It's all about them. I mean, God rest her soul. She died 2 years ago, grandma. Granddad died 7 to 8 years ago. Yeah. They were the most incredible I mean, wisdom, I can't, I'm not just, forget the religious thing, because they were a bit over the top with the religion, but as people, you couldn't get a structure like that. My grandparents were solid, they were real, they were not impressed by anybody who had a big car or this or that. I don't care, are you good people or not?
Yes,
and that's the kind of people they were. So it was like, I grew up with people who were hardworking people, who, you know, had my grandmother had like 3 jobs. Raised 8 children with my granddad, and they bought all their own houses here and in the Caribbean, and you know, because I'm mixed, I'm Cuban, Jamaican, right?
Oh,
and they,
yeah,
and basically, you know, they worked their asses off, and I saw that growing up, and I'm like, no, I mean, you can't get it wrong when you have that as a structure.
Yeah.
So anyway, so I put everything to bed after I did What Not to Wear. What Not to Wear blew up 4 million people a week. It was going great, and I was fabulous. Got sick of that afterwards, and I love helping people, but I felt like I was losing my music, and I felt like they were trying to make me into this presenter, like, you know, like a just like a Marlene Clark sort of thing.
Yeah. So
I didn't want that.
Again.
I didn't want that. Yeah. And I felt that it was almost like I just kept feeling like they didn't want me to sing. I could feel that they didn't want me to sing. They just don't want me to sing. They just want me to.
They want you to be the figurehead.
Misha, you talk well, you do well, but don't sing. That's what I felt. And I was like, you know what? So I was done with that after 2.5 years, finished that. Then I was like, you know what, I need people to remember me as a singer again, so I need to go away for a while. Let me go away for a while. Even when I was doing What Not to Wear, I was still doing Ronnie Scott's Jazz Cafe.
Yes,
I was still doing all my stuff.
Yeah, we've always done the jazz route.
Oh yeah, I've always done that. And I just thought, let me back off for a while from the media, because, you know, when it gets to that point where they start asking you to do Celebrity Big Brother 4 or 5 times over the space of 6 years, it's a bit of a joke.
Yes, it's insulting.
You kind of realise that's what people perceive me as, so I need to get out.
Who can we get?
You could be a contestant on The Voice or a judge on The Voice. Which would you rather be?
Right.
Yes.
Well, I think you know the answer.
You know the answer to that.
So we just loved doing it. We loved to make music. Music was a thing.
Yes.
Music was a thing I did
yes.
because I was obsessed with it. I loved doing it. I didn't want to go and play with my mates. I wanted to make music.
So why would you want to be on?
That's my whole point. That's what I'm saying.
Yeah,
it's
exactly.
Like it's very like how suddenly artists have become that person.
Commodities, yeah.
It is
yeah.
For me. I still, I mean, Beyonce is another one. I love Goblet. She's the sweetest
yeah.
girl. If you ever
yeah.
meet her, she's lovely.
Yeah, no,
but Jesus Christ, she's like a can of beans.
Yeah.
She's like a can of coke.
Yeah, that's
you right. know, there's no.
You lose your identity.
Where is the
music?
No,
that?
Where's the musician here?
Yes.
Yeah, and she is a musical person.
She is. Yeah.
And she's got a great voice and everything. And this is why, you know, when you saw Michael Jackson die, Whitney Houston die, this was the last of real artists.
Yes.
Really.
Yes.
This really sent.
That was one of our questions. Where's music going today? What
where's
about
music going today?
It's not the end. It's not the end. It's not the end. What's about to happen is. No, let me tell you what's happening. What's going on now? It's all the same. It's always a cycle of things. You know, you have
yeah.
the cyclical. You know, you have like maybe. I have to be honest, though, this manufacturing thing has gone on a bit longer
yeah,
than I thought.
Too long.
It's
too
really
long.
Long.
Tribute thing
right?
as
too
well.
Long.
Tribute
yeah,
thing
yeah.
as well.
Is there a Mission Paris tribute band?
No, no,
you need to stop.
please,
God, not yet.
Please.
Not yet. But no, you know, what you're starting to see now, you see people like Pharrell Williams
yes.
incorporating, you know, Nile Rodgers.
The crime I am accusing to buy and not be using.